Hey everyone, so if you didn't already know from my other videos, I am moving, hence the extremely crowded room here. But I'm just about to pack up all my makeup stuff because I'm moving in just a couple days. I have a box started down here and a bunch of my glossy boxes just over here that I'm going to pack stuff in. And I keep most of my makeup in this desk here, so I thought I would just show you it and kind of show you my makeup collection, I guess, as we're going along. I'm going to try and break it down into different categories as I'm going through, as far as like foundation and eyeshadows and mascaras and just things like that. Although right now I gotta tell you, it's a crazy mess. So yeah, this is usually where I film. I thought I'd just show you. It's dirty, as you can see, but usually my camera sits up here and then I have a mirror. And then my makeup is just not that organized. I have a few boxes in there, but that's like the drawer up there. And then this one's a crazy disaster. So I'm actually excited to move because I can organize this a little bit better. And then I have this down here with just like more palettes and makeup bags and stuff like that. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this type of video. I definitely don't think I have a super large or spectacular makeup collection, but it's definitely come a long way in the recent years, and I definitely wouldn't have quite this much if I wasn't doing YouTube videos. So I kind of collect stuff to review and try out different products, so that's why I have more than I have in the past. But yeah, if you see anything along the way that you'd like me to review or do a tutorial with, definitely let me know in the comments down below. Okay, so I pulled up my foundations and my primers, and I'm going to try and run through these really, really fast. This is my Body Shop Day Cream Hard Candy Primer, Benefit Primer, and Bare Minerals Sample Primer. Oh man, this is going to be a long video. Okay, a whole bunch of BB creams from Pond's, different colors, some that I haven't opened yet. These are MAC Studio Fix Powders, and this is a sample Bare Minerals Foundation Powder. Then I have two Revlon Color Stay Whip Foundations in two different colors. I have a Revlon Nearly Naked Foundation, Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Plus. Two CoverGirl Stay Fabulous Foundations, which I've been loving a lot recently. And this one I've had forever, Maybelline Instant Age Rewind, and I don't usually use this one. So yeah. I forgot to add this into foundations. This is from the Sephora VIB sale, and I'm not sure if I posted a haul of this before or after this video, but I'll link it down below if I did. But it's a whole bunch of different BB creams. So there's that. Powder-wise, I have my NARS Setting Powder, my Rimmel Stay Matte, my Essence Mattifying Compact, which is actually pretty terrible, so I'm probably going to check this out. It's good. I'm kind of cleaning out my makeup as we go. This is the Tarte Smooth Operator Powder. Bronzers, I have an e.l.f. Baked Bronzer, a Rimmel Bronzer, really old one, NYC Bronzer, Too Faced Chocolate Soleil, this Pixi one that I got in an Ipsy bag, NARS Laguna Bronzer, and then this Tarte Bronzer, which is newer to me, and this is Park Avenue Princess. There's a blush in here too. And then for highlighters, I have the Bare Minerals, what's this called, Pure Radiance, Lorac Spotlit, Laura Mercier Golden Mosaic, Urban Decay Brown Sugar, the High Beam, the What's Up from Benefit, and the Hard Candy Tiki, I think this is Tiki, yep, highlighter. Alright, and these are my blushes. These two are from Milani. This one's from Avon. I have a Tarte blush, Wet n Wild, three from NYX, and one's a Mosaic one. This is Physicians Formula, Glossy Box, Model Co. This is the Tarte Flush, the Stila Convertible Color. I have two blushes from Essence, two Maybelline Dream Bouncy Blushes, and two from Hard Candy, although this one's more like a highlighter. Alright, onto brows. I have the Maybelline Great Lash Clear Mascara, a Sephora Eyebrow Pencil, which I haven't opened yet because I'm finishing up my Milani Eyebrow Pencil, and then I have the Milani Brow Powder, Eyelash Curler, and a whole bunch of mascara. Not sure why I have so many, and so many open right now, too. I have this Lash Primer, and this lash primer from the Body Shop, CoverGirl Clump Crusher, the Rocket Mascara, this one's M by Michelle Phan, this one I haven't opened yet, it's the Tarte Lights Camera Flashes, Jordana Best Lash Extreme, this is a Rimmel Lash Accelerator, it's supposed to help your lashes grow, I haven't seen it work yet, and then a bunch I haven't opened yet, the Jordana Best Lash Extreme Lengthening, a backup of the Best Lash Extreme, this is It's So Big, and a Scandalized Mascara. Okay, I forgot one brow product. I have an Avon pencil as well. And then here are my concealers. I have the Bobbi Brown Corrector. This one is Essence Cover Stick. L'Oreal True Match, Rimmel Wake Me Up, 2 Maybelline Dream Lumis, this is CoverGirl and Olay, and this is Essence Match to Cover. And then for eyeliners, I have Rimmel in brown, L'Oreal Voluminous in black, this gold one from Essence, a brown one from Essence, and black one from Avon. This one's Elite. I think it's charcoal. I'm not sure. A lot of these I get in boxes, like subscription boxes. Scandalized from Rimmel in purple, and an Essence one in purple. Oh no, that's Hard Candy in purple. Fabuliner from Jordana in brown, a Scandalized from Rimmel in nude, a black one from Jordana. This one's from Starlooks, and it's black. This one's from Starlooks, and it's like sparkly purple. I just got that one. This one's Blitz from Pop. It's also purple. 2 gel eyeliners, 1 in brown, 1 in black from Maybelline, and a couple backup ones, 2 from e.l.f. and 1 from Jordana. And one of my favorite products, cream eyeshadow bases. Over here are just eye primers. I have the NYX base, Avon base, a NYX HD base, and an e.l.f. eyelid primer. These are my jumbo kind of eyeshadow pencils. All of these are from Urban Decay, and you can tell which one is the most loved. That's the color Sin. I love that one. This one's Pixie in Peach. These two are from, or no, this one's from Avon. It's a green. These two are from Sephora. I love the quality of these. And this is a Rimmel Scandalized one. And these three are from NYX. Try and get closer. And then these ones are Maybelline color tattoos, a bunch of different colors. I have 2 cream eyeshadow bases from Avon and 1 cream eyeshadow base from Hard Candy. It's this teal blue color. So yeah. All right, and this is the Lorac 3D Liquid Luster Drops, and then a bunch of pigments. These are just sample ones from MAC in a bunch of different colors here. These three are the L'Oreal Infallible colors, which I love. These two are from NYX. I've had these forever. This is a color tattoo pure pigment. And this one came in some sort of subscription box. And then these are just single eyeshadows. I feel like there's more somewhere, but the rest of them are pretty much palettes, which I'll go over in a sec. I have Essence, 2 from NYX, Wet n Wild. This is Sally Girl. It's terrible. I'll probably throw that out. This is NYX. Oh, that's a blush, actually, but I've been using it as an eyeshadow because I like it more as an eyeshadow. And this one's BH Cosmetics. Alright, and these are my smaller palettes as far as eyeshadow goes. This one actually has a blush in it. This one's from Clinique. I have my Naked Basics. This is CoverGirl. And then 2 from Essence. This one is L'Oreal. I'm going to flip that one over. That's BH Cosmetics. And the rest of these are all from Wet n Wild. And these are all the bigger palettes that I had in the cupboard. These two actually aren't eyeshadow. This one's a blush palette that I got at IMATS, and underneath is a concealer palette. Then I have my Urban Decay Naked 2 and Naked 1, and my Bon Jovi palette from The Balm. This one is an Avon one that I've had forever and ever and ever, but the pigment is actually really nice. This one's an e.l.f. beauty book, and then this one I probably had longer than the Avon one. This is Artistic Cosmetics, and I got it years and years ago at a women's trade show, but it has every color, so I hang on to it. And this one is the NYX Dark Shadows palette. Alright, and lip products is a little bit crazy. This isn't all of it. I keep a lot of it in my purse, but I just went through and weeded out a bunch of stuff that I don't use. And I also need to go through this and figure out what is confirmed to have gluten in it, and decide if I'm throwing it out or not, because I want to try and eliminate the gluten if possible, but I will show you what I currently have. This is like lip balm stuff, so the baby lips. This is the sugar one. This one is Blistex. This one's my favorite. It's from Red Apple Lipstick. It's the Raleigh Balm, it's called, and I have a little sample of it here, too. And this is EOS Lip Balm. Then I have the 3 Red Apple Lipsticks that I own and a whole bunch of sample color ones. These are all Revlon Lip Butters. Coming closer. A really old MAC lip gloss, and these two are Urban Decay. That's a lipstick. That's a lip gloss that I got with my Naked One palette. Quite a while ago now. These are 3 lip liners, but honestly I don't use lip liners that often. Jumbo lip pencils. This one's Pop Beauty. That one is Jelly Pong. This one I just got and really like from Via Bombshell. CoverGirl, and these are 3 Revlon Just Bitten. These are Revlon lip glosses. A Buxom lip gloss. I have some more of these upstairs. I love those. Revlon Apocalypse. two Revlon lipsticks, and a, I think this is L'Oreal and Hot Plum, the Vivids, a Revlon lip gloss, NYX lip gloss, NYX lipstick, a Maybelline lip gloss. This one's called Model Co. again from one of those bags. From a glossy box. This one's glossy box. These are Essence. And that's an e.l.f. one. It's just like a nude one. Alright, and some last random bits. I have my Urban Decay DeSlick Makeup Setting Spray, e.l.f. Setting Spray, e.l.f. HD Powder. This is a glitter mascara that I doubt I'll ever use. A whole bunch of random lashes and some lash glue. And then I have other things like all my tools in there and some brushes in there and other things like that. But I'm not going to go over all that. So yeah, I'm just going to finish packing all this. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know, like I said, if you'd like to see any looks with anything that I showed or reviews of any products. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Bye.